Today, we're going to talk about the 4% rule. This is a frequently cited rule of thumb for how to spend from a portfolio in retirement. To help with this discussion, I'm joined by my colleague, Sharon Calhoun. Sharon is a senior wealth advisor and is the director of advanced planning at Vector Wealth. Sharon, thanks for joining me today. First off, can you explain in greater detail the 4% rule?
Thank you, Jason. Yes. So the 4% rule at a high level is a rule that is often cited as a framework for a specific amount that you can withdraw safely from your retirement portfolio with a high level of certainty that it will last for at least 30 years.
Sharon, you and I, as well as our clients broadly, know that we don't use or subscribe to the 4% rule of thumb. Can you talk about the main reasons as to why that is?
The research for that 4.5% rule, where that came from, was actually based on a worst case scenario for an individual who retired on October 1st, 1968. And then that individual would have suffered 3 years of poor stock market returns and high inflation. When the research was done, the target portfolio that they were using was a portfolio consisting of 30% US large cap stock, 20% of US small cap stock, and 50% of the intermediate term US government bonds. The research has actually shown that retirees facing more favorable market conditions, on the other hand, may have been actually able to withdraw successfully up to 13% of their portfolio.
Now, shifting gears to how we think about retirement planning, we designed Sojourn, our bucket-based financial planning application, to be more flexible and specific to each client's circumstances. Sharon, can you expand on how we think about planning for distributions and withdrawals and how that might contrast with the 4% rule?
Sure. As you know, we use Sojourn, our proprietary financial planning software system, which factors in age, life expectancy, and the amount of guaranteed monthly income from sources such as Social Security or pensions. We then arrive with what is needed from a cash flow perspective from the portfolio. And then we overlay that with your investment policy, which is matched up, of course, with your specific time horizon. We don't assign just a specific cookie cutter percentage to your situation. And we look to customize everything specifically to your financial needs.
We have the privilege of working with our clients and helping guide them throughout their financial life. If there's one thing we learned, it's that no two financial lives are the same.
The final note I want to make on this is one size does not fit all, and the number that you choose could actually really be anything.
Sharon, as always, thank you for joining in this discussion. We covered a topic here that's very important to us as well as our clients. And as you can tell, we spend a lot of time thinking about retirement planning and withdrawal strategies. And while rules of thumb, there are several of them out there, they can be a guide, but in our view, should not be solely relied upon.